All right, looks like a double frontliner for no value. It's good information from Restart there. I wasn't aware that the ultimate shield didn't block that. But anyway, Rampart and Asana for no value, along with the Grimalicious and Nyx. Grimal and Nyx love Evil's Laboratory. Lots of stuff to shoot over for Grimalicious. Of course, we already talked about Nyx. On the other side, Cookie Cutter's picking up that Zuki, of course, along with Garrison. The first time we've seen Gary here today, and we didn't see him at all yesterday, so he's one of those seldom-picked frontliners that I'm really excited to see.
All right, looks like these teams getting ready, so we'll hop into spectate mode. And we are ready to roll here with this game. Nice pirate skin over here on Zuki, and definitely some garish colors coming out of Finn. These players having a lot of fun with these skins. There are a lot of skins and styles in the game right now, and a lot of them are fantastic. Really put your own personality on these different characters.
Yeah, and, you know, not everybody likes, like, the level 10 skins or the Golden Age that you get from buying a big-time
Founders
pack.
How can you not like the Golden Age skins? Come on.
Well, they're great. They're great, but now what they're doing is they're coming out with some of the great skins that are coming out after those. I personally like the Razor skins and the Curse skins just to play on those because they're so neat. They're just different than anything else in the game.
Yeah, and if you guys like those, there's definitely been a lot of good promotions. Razor has done some chroma skins where the colored parts of characters constantly change colors just like their keyboards. And then Curse has done a full set of skins as well for, I think they've each done 3 different characters. But you guys can check them out. Yep. Those may still be going on. There's definitely a lot of cross promotions. So check out the Atlas Reactor website. Watch their Twitter for some free skins here and there.
And what that means is it's really great because that means Atlas Reactor is getting some traction in the world. You know, it's not just us sitting here, you know, wasting our time on a game that's going to die off in a few months. This is going to stick around for a long while, guys. I think this has a very good potential to go big time once it goes live. So that's why we're spending our time, Restart and I, Pepper Titan, everybody in the Prep Phase League back office, basically, spending our free time here, just getting involved, doing the extra mile here for the community, because we want you guys to get involved and have a lot of fun while we're here, and we know it's going to kick off big time when the game goes live.
Absolutely. Looks like they're just finishing up some final things. They'll get ready to go in a minute, and then they may do some changing of their catalysts, although I don't see a ton of effects that require it on here. I mean, the big ones you've got to concern with are Unstoppable is obviously a big change if the enemy team has a lot of movement effects. You have to be aware of maybe you want Mining or Shield. And then the cooldown reduction is sometimes really good if you have some wombo combos either on your team or the enemy team that you want to be able to dash out of. But while there are some combinations here, specifically you've got that Rampart pull through just a lot of traps with both Nyx and Grimalicious. There's the big Zuki when she starts to throw down her combos and put bombs on you and put traps on the ground and do ultimates as well. You definitely want the dash up for that. I don't know if you shy away from your comfort picks and your favorite setup for this, for either of these compositions.
I think the biggest combo that we can possibly see in this game is going to be from Cookie Cutters. Zuki big one with the Celeste trap in the middle and then the Finn ultimate pulling somebody right in the middle of it. That could be a thing. And I think that would be probably the most damaging combo we could see in this whole game.
Hopefully we see them have the coordination to be able to pull that off, because it really takes some careful timing to be able to line things like that up.
You got to think about cooldowns, dash cooldowns, catalyst cooldowns. Can they have an out to get out of that situation? That's what you have to consider as well. Or you just want to force it out of them. I know there's some numbers, guys, and some damage calculators out there in Twitch chat, man. Let me know if that's going to be the most damaging combo, or what could it be in these 4-man comps to do the most possible damage in whatever situation for these teams.
All right, looks like everybody's loading up Evo's Lavatory. Get ready. again, tell us your favorite teams and who you predict is going to win for this match, because it is about to get underway. We'll have a turn or two of positioning. This is one where your early positioning matters a lot, especially with Azuki on one of the teams and a Gremolition on the others. If you're in a predictable spot, even behind cover, you can still be outplayed, outpredicted by either of their abilities and take a lot of damage before the fight's really even started.
Yeah, it'll be really interesting to see the opening gambit from these two teams. Turn number one, the movement phase, very, very important to get the proper positioning here. You don't want to be too close, but you don't want to be too far away, because Grimmo can shoot over that wall. Zuki's big one's definitely going to be coming out turn number two, trying to poke at people and get them out of those good spots they want to be in.
All right, looks like we're ready to start here. We're going to have to zoom way out just to see both teams on the long side of this map. This red team takes a very centered position, blue team off to the side.
Looks like red team traditionally trying to protect that might buff, but it's not going to do any good with the Celeste on the map. Lava Cookie is just going to take that away with a basic attack. And Gommelnok's taking the forward spot, but he is behind that good wall there. But Gremolicious typically is going to shoot either at those two cover spots on the side of that wall or directly behind it. We'll have to see if he's safe in his position.
When it comes to buffs, dashes beat Celeste, Celeste beats traps, and traps beat dashes. So it's a big game there of who can play versus what. We'll see too if that might trip the edge of the attack. But Lava Cookie gets some damage on Jay right off the bat. Gommel trying to do a predict, not going to be able to hit anybody with that ability. Didn't really have a full move to go. Jay Knight turns around and does a pull, expecting the jump in from that one, but that'll mean that pull is not up for a few turns, and Rampart can do nothing at a distance of more than really two squares without that pull up. That is such a big threat gone early.
Yeah, definitely, and that was an exceptional bit of play by the Gremolicious and the Nyx. Got some damage on all's garrison, but the big story here is the weakened mine sitting on the ground. He ran right through one of them, so if he jumps in, his rockets are going to go, he's going to land on somebody's head, but it's not going to do enough damage.
Slow mod coming down on the enemy team, and here comes the jump directly in the center, rooting two people inside of that, and Jay Knight will be slowed as well, so they're trying to get everybody as deep into this damage as possible. Looks like a bunch of shots missing, teams just too far away. Very common on Evos. Bright will hit. Oh, they are all about predicting the jump ins, and they do get it this turn as Trasic hits as well. So Odd taking a lot of damage despite dashing this turn. Good prediction.
Garrison in a really bad way right now. Went all in on the enemy team, but he doesn't really have the support. Gommelnok's way out of position to be in line of sight to give him that shield or that heal that he desperately needs this turn to survive.
And he's actually going to Catalyst out this turn, has been taking too much damages in directly in the middle of the enemy team, and unfortunately his team has not moved up far enough to be able to support him with damage here. So they're going to put a trap on Aw, and then Aw's going to flash out, so hopefully they catch anybody on follow there. Damage coming in on Bright Shadow, but with the shield up they won't take a lot, and they'll deal some in return for the direct hits. Now Nyx is going a little bit low. He'll have to stick next to the health. Gommel again trying to predict the enemy team, not able to hit anybody there.
Now I want to point out that was not necessarily all doing something wrong on Garrison on that turn. Oh, looks like the big one, the big bang's coming out trying to knock him out, but he did get out safely. All did what he wanted to do, what he was supposed to do, in my opinion. His team unfortunately failed to back him up. Now Gommelnox hasn't moved for three turns. I don't know what his plan is, but he may be just trying to play it a little bit too safe here. May it be better to get into that cover position right next to him and be in line of sight to help his team.
Well, it looks like the sit and spray is finally going to pay off as his target just clips the edge of Fruit Roz here. The dash in from Bright Shadow as well, so he will get two. Persistence definitely paying off in that case. They're going to hit two people with Zuki bombs. Again, Lava Cookie being able to get some damage as well. The spray from Gommelnox are finally putting down some good damage from this Cookie Cutters team. The trap hitting Jay Knight, and they will be rooted Fura is able to also put in some damage and all going really low to 47. Now 25 thanks to the bombs from Tazrek covering all these defensive positions. So if you try and go and cover, you're going to take a little bit extra. And now Oz at 15 with no jump, no dash catalyst. They're in trouble.
Yeah, no question about it. I mean, he went in, like I said, I cannot stress this enough. If you go in as a frontliner, you have to have the support of your team, and it just did not come. They stayed back. They wanted to play safe, which is a solid strategy, but you have to do it. You have to do one of the two. You can't go aggressive with one guy and be super safe with the other three. Just won't work out for you.
The sturgeon is in.
Nice heal coming out and some shields instantly bring Awe back up to 76 from that super low total at the start of the turn. Remy's going to jump out, does not want to be next to Bright Shadow, and land directly on the healing, stealing that away from Nyx. So Nyx not only slowed, not only taking damage, not able to heal, as the bombs finally go off on J-Knight and Bright Shadow, and Fura's turning back to again deal damage to Awe, but that healing just enough to keep them over 30 health. Gommel rooted in place, so they will not be able to go help their team. And Jay ends up in the middle of the enemy team, but Bright Shadow following Fura's. Unfortunately, Nyx just in a world of hurt here.
Gommel knocks on Finn, finally able to save Awe from disaster, basically. Now, Remedy on the Zuki, basically has that mited mod on her jump way, so that's why the sticky bombs did 38 instead of 30, and now she has the ultimate available. Is Nyx gonna stay there and just take the death? I mean, they're in some serious trouble. Zuki ult is no joke.
I'm not sure if they think she'll use it here, but it's always dangerous to tempt a Zuki. As the bubble comes out from Gommel Nox, so again, a low health from Awe turns into over 70 health. Remini's ultimate does go off in the prep phase and will do damage in the blast phase. The jump from Awe over behind Tazrek, not only doing damage, but a bubble delivery system. Fura stays in place, says, I'll just take the death now, save my cooldowns for later. Bright Shadow does dash out of that. Awe getting some nice damage with the missiles as well. Really putting a good amount of hurt on Tazrek for being just one person jumping in. Damage going down on Gommel Nox in return, just a few mines. And here comes the taunted Zuki ultimate, taking down that Nyx with a nice 44 damage. So that must be that had might. So that's got to be a through walls. You should take note of that damage if you're a player, and definitely note this Zuki will be able to hit you behind walls. Good information to have.
Yeah, no doubt. So Remedy, the team captain, drawing first blood for Team Cookie Cutters, getting on the scoreboard there. 1-0 at the start of turn number 8. Bright Shadow Wolf wouldn't have gone down there, but he did choose to use that Catalyst Flash to get away from that damage. Very smart decision, in my opinion.
If that was a full powered ult, that would easily be 62 or more damage there. So would have been super low. As J-Knight now slowed, not able to get away. Tazrek jumping away from the front liner, able to deal damage to Remini as well. So good moves all around there. Gommel Nox able to put down that eel that will be bouncing around with three members of the enemy team around it. Awe missing due to the dash. And it looks like J-Knight will be stuck in the inner square of this giant Zuki bomb.
Kind of questionable to use the pull there for the rampart. That's a long, long range ability. He could have just done some basic attack damage to Remedy. That's the only person that was there. I guess they just didn't want him running off and getting away, but kind of a waste. They could have maybe snagged him back towards them if he got away in vision.
And it looks like teams... Okay, was that the same? The viewer went to negative 3 seconds for me. I was a little concerned there for a moment, but it looks like everything will be ready. J-Knight using the dash to fully protect his team in what would be an excellent move, except for the fact that Zuki did actually jump out of the way, did not want to take all this damage. Now streaming live. Gommel Nox will bump against the shield, giving a little extra 10 health to J-Knight. Because the bomb comes from the air, it does go over the shield, just completely erasing that heal and dealing just a little more, but only 20 total damage since it was the outer level. Red team grouped up in the corner, and Nyx stealth in the middle of blue.
Yeah, Nick's in a really good position here, completely invisible. Nobody knows where in the heck he is. Fruruz, good spot to be in. He's probably going to try to duck into the camouflage, though, just nearby him after he makes this shot. But effectively disengaging from the fight is Remedy. Very good decision to catalyst away.
Yeah, nobody was able to follow up on him this turn and doesn't even know where he is. Fruruz taking the shot at the close member of the enemy team. Buggers. A delivery coming in at the packed up enemy team, dealing 37 damage to both Bright and J-Knight. Together with the focus from Lavaka, he will bring J-Knight down to 14 health. Tazrik trying to hit all those squares in the center area, thinking that's Wazuki jump, but no, she was around the corner. Now Bright Shadow does have line of sight on them, but Remini's at full health and Bright Shadow really low, so...
Yeah, and Lava Cookie Gamonox, the Celeste, and the Dr. Finn sitting right in the middle of some trouble there, but they both have their ultimates, as does the Nyx for Fruruz, so very dangerous for them to be standing right there.
Shield coming out from J-Knight, trying desperately to live, but this dash going directly through the shield, as all dashes do. Always off on the side, picking up some health is why we haven't seen him for a while. The ultimate coming down from Fruruz unfortunately won't hit Lava Cookie due to the dash. Remedy not able to hit Bright Shadow because of their dash. Their dashes all around and being the winning moves, none were predicted. All of them hit their mark.
Yeah, big time ultimate down for Team No Value on that Nyx. I mean, and he's right out in the open. Looks like he was expecting Gamelnox maybe to move out of that spot, but he has been there forever. He loves that spot, apparently. He's not going anywhere anytime soon, doesn't look like.
He has set up camp. He has his marshmallows out. He is, you know, a fire going. That is his spot. Bright Shadow Wolf dashing across the map, trying to live more than anything else than really protect anybody. Bubble from Gamelnox going to protect themselves here.
Will hurt you.
Lava Cookie setting up a trap as they know the enemy team is around here somewhere, doing what they can. Bouncing bombs coming over the wall, not able to hit. Fruruz does able to take a direct shot, but was out in the open, so will take not only a direct hit from Remedy, but the bubble from Gommel. Lava Cookie picking up the buff even before running over it. Just abusing that power of picking up power-ups. Oh, it's right next to me, but grab it anyways.
That was an excellent bubble from Gamelnox. He was really in no big danger there, but the whole point of that was to slow down Fruruz and make sure he does not get where he wants to go this turn. And now he's still out in the open, no cover bonus anywhere to be seen near that Nyx. He's going to be taking some more upfront damage, looks like.
Shields coming out from Bright Shadow Wolf, extending their health to 91, despite being at, I believe, less than 30 actual health. But shield huge here. Bright Shadow whiffing due to the jump by Remedy, are able to take a big smack directly in Trazrek's face. And the missile's coming out as well. Fruruz doing a little return damage on Gamelnox, but the shield still preventing all of it, so just giving him energy. Lava Cookie able to throw some bombs over walls, takes 12 return damage, is fine with it for the amount of damage they do, as they did break Bright Shadow Shield.
Watch out for the undertow! It's a doozy.
Here comes the puns of Dr. Finn, throwing this ultimate over the wall directly on two members of the enemy team. Will finish off Bright Shadow Wolf, as well as put Trazrek in a bad spot, directly in line of a lot of the enemy team here.
Yeah, choosing to completely ignore the Nyx that turn, so very good change of strategy there. Four Team Cookie Cutters taking a 3-0 lead at the start of the turn, number 14. Now they're in a really strong position to get that win number one that they desperately need here to try to take that fifth spot away with two wins on No Value.
And J-Knight went to a perfect position. Unfortunately, the shield isn't up. They will be able to block some damage from Trazrek just from body blocking, but with the AoEs of the enemy team, without that shield, it'll just go directly through. Instead, Awe chooses to jump behind, rooting both of them in place for next turn, ensuring they can't join their team, as Remedy fires directly in their face with Might, 40 and 28 damage. Lava Cooking doing direct damage as well while picking up some bonuses. Trazrek exploiting these mines, predicting the jump, and throwing the ultimate down on Remedy as well, able to bring them below 50 health. A pull coming out as well, that'll pull Remedy directly in, not able to go over any of the mines, and J-Knight not able to move where they wanted to afterwards, but does mean his spin will hit a lot of the enemy team.
Yeah, Team Captain Remedy, his catalyst is down, his jump is down, so I think it's going to be curtains for him, but Sarek really needs to get out of dodge here on Grimalicious, unless he wants to have a trade kill coming in for Remedy.
I am unbreakable.
Looks like the shield coming down, just blocking Remedy off. They can't even jump. Uses a catalyst, so they may actually survive this. Very smart move from that Turtle Tech there. The jump coming out from Trazric to keep themselves alive at low 20s. Slow coming out from J-Knight, so still going to be in trouble afterwards. Furuz just trying to slow down the enemy team as well as the AoE damage, but ultimate from Lava Cookie dealing 50 damage. A spray from Gommel Nox hitting J-Knight from the side as well as J-Knight was just surrounded. There's no direction they can put the shield in that would prevent more than one of those attacks. And that's really how to deal with Rampart.
Absolutely, and notice that Remedy was so close to Grimalicious when he dashed away, couldn't get any damage on the Zuki to finish her off. That would have been 20 damage, that would have been enough. Oh, actually, no, it wouldn't have been. He had the Turtle Tech.
Remedy now gonna ult. Remember, does have that through walls. We did see that earlier, so this will be interesting to see how that turns out. As Lava Cookie puts up a trap trying to predict the enemy team, Remedy able to hit three members of the opposite team, but Bright Shadow expecting it will dash to finish off Remedy, so Remedy is going to go down here. Traz putting out mines to ensure that, as well as do a little extra R, and here comes that excellent damage finishing off the Grimalicious, as well as dealing damage to Grey Knight. Furu is doing a little bit extra in the background. R directly in J-Knight's face, going to shoot him as well as Gommel, so they're also focusing down this Rampart. Well, his shield is down.
Garrison surviving with one HP there. I was sure he was going to go down, and he's the guy that gets to the health globe first.
Four turns
does
left.
He have his jump available? He does not, and of course his catalyst
sure he needs
is down
it.
As well earlier.
Cooldown's down for the enemy team. Nobody in range. I'm not sure he needs his jump right now. I think a full move may be in order.
Yeah, it looks like he is going to go over that haste buff, so he's going to have a lot of running to do at the start of the next turn.
Be still. Able to break away from the enemy team. Bright Shadow Wolf able to lock down Gommel Nox, just trying to keep him away from what everybody else is doing here. And that really offers no cover from what their team's trying to do. Furuz poking away at Lava Cookie in this 1v1 shot fest, or at least Nyx thinks it is. Lava Cookie trying to help the team, and Furuz just saying, no, I am dealing damage, as he goes directly over the Might Buff. Wow.
Furuz, if you've noticed, off to the side, like you said, a little 1v1 going on between he and Lava Cookie's Celeste. The Nyx has been getting the better of Lava Cookie every single time because he's never in the place where she expects him to be. She hasn't been able to return any of this damage. She's got two basic attacks off for 34 pop on Lava Cookie with no return damage whatsoever.
Bow from Gommel gonna put Lava Cookie up at a respectable bit of health. Together with the dash will mean that Lava Cookie's gonna be safe no matter what. Unfortunately, that bubble not gonna be able to slow or hit anybody as Furuz dashes off to the side, well invisible. The trap is going to root Bright Shadow Wolf, and it looks like the ultimate ability by Awn, not able to hit Lava Cookie as well thanks to that dash. Trazric's gonna mine the health and then just poke off Gommel here. Did expect the dash, or didn't even target Lava Cookie.
Two turns left.
Again, Furuz playing some mind games, has the invisibility dash for his catalyst, so he went invisible as soon as he catalysted away. Nobody has any idea where this guy is.
I mean, he's got to be within two squares. That is the distance. So if you can cover that area, you can make sure he's there, but instead they're going to just try for some healing instead. Might and the ultimate coming out from Nyx. Well, they will pick up some healing on Lava Cookie. This is going to be some significant damage. Remedy does try and cover most of the area, but misses where Furuz is. He is playing some mind games. As the ultimate comes out, hits both Remedy and Lava Cookie, and has the extra damage on low health for 75. Such a huge amount through that shield. J-Knight able to pull in Gommel, and is going to do some significant damage with Bright Shadow there as well. The two frontliners right next to Gauntlet.
I want to point out this right now. Lava Cookie played that little Celeste minigame where she picked up buffs off the map. She picked up two Garrison Health Globes with her basic attack. That gave her 10 and 10 health for 20 total. If she wouldn't have done that, that ult kills her.
Oh, unfortunately, not in a fantastic position right now at only 20 health. The jumps coming in from two members of Blue Team just to stay alive as they jump over to the side. Synchronized dashing. Fruit Russ is going to poke on Gommelnox as J-Knight makes sure that his team is safe, blocking this spray. Trasric going to try and just mine up the map as best they can.
Unfortunate for no value. This was the end of turn number 20. Cookie Cutter's going to take game number one, 4-1. And I don't know, it's kind of a sloppy match, I think. But in the end, they came out on top.
Yeah, definitely a lot of back and forth. A lot of, you know, abilities that were just missed due to dashes, due to mind games. Not the cleanest, just straight up damage and kills. And that's why you saw it go to time. Is all these teams doing the best that they can to confuse the opponents, to get them off their game, and to try and really... I really hope they fix that soon.
You can go ahead and close it out. I'll talk about the numbers if you don't mind, if you want me to do that. Fruit Ruzz on the Knicks for no value put up 524 damage that game, leading the pack for both sides. So he was doing work, and of course the last three or four turns at the end they're really playing some mind games with the team Cookie Cutters, especially with Lava Cookie there on the Celeste. Couldn't find him anywhere she tried. Number two was Remini, of course, on the Zuki, 439. But we want to look at those supports. Their contributions are typically off the charts here. No support for no value, by the way. I actually 20 turns in, I just now realized that. But Gommelnox getting 661 contribution with 420 of that comes from shields and heals, 241 damage from the Finn. That's why he's one of the top picks right now as well. Really can do it all.
And no value went with the double frontline composition. What wasn't able to put on the pressure that a double frontline needs to really be able to take that down.
Yeah, you really got to just lock somebody down and keep them right in front of you and just chase them around the map, burn their escapes, and then keep on them. Over and over and over again. It's basically a cat and mouse game, and whoever wins the game usually. And in this case, Cookie Cutters won the match.
All right, so setting up this next match. Looks like teams will be getting ready. A little post-match delay there as both teams get back in and discuss what happened. So I don't think we'll be seeing again the double front. Two teams have gone for double frontliners today. In one, it worked somewhat solidly. In this one, it just didn't work out for them as they just weren't able to apply the pressure. But it just shows how without a support healing you and without the extra damage from the extra firepower, you really have to be putting some excellent pressure on the other team to make up for those losses in your team composition. And team composition really matters in higher level play here.
Absolutely. It's not like, you know, you're running into your solo queue game, you're just going to spam pup every game, you know, and just do whatever you want, because these guys are coordinated. They're talking on the voice comms. They're picking to their strengths and trying to pick to the weaknesses of their opponents. And you might see some strange comps come out, but they definitely have a plan in mind. So, again, that's why they're sitting on that side and I'm sitting over here talking about it, because I can't do that, guys. I'm not that smart. But it looks like we're going to be on Cloudspire this time. Cookie Cutters, I don't recall who got to pick that time, but Cookie Cutters definitely likes Cloudspire. Wouldn't be surprised if that was their pick.
Yeah, we will see. I didn't see exactly who picked it up. I'm sure chat can remember for us. It may have been the home team. I don't know. But it does look like we will go away for the first bans right now.
Yeah, 25 more seconds until at least, or at most, until we see who Cookie Cutters is going to ban. It's going to be that gray this time around.
Gray taking away the first ban of the match. We'll see who the first ban is for no value. What didn't they like on this Cookie Cutters team? Because with Cookie Cutters taking the win there, then they probably feel pretty comfortable with their strategy. And it's up to the other team to disrupt them at this point. They decide no Rask for this one.
Yeah, kind of a standard ban against Cloudspire. Rask on a very small map can do tremendous amounts of, or he can create tremendous amounts of havoc wherever he wants to go. And Finn picked up as the first pick for Cookie Cutters. No value gets two. What do you expect to see?
Well, Lockwood was not banned right away, and Helio wasn't banned this map, so he may be a good choice. Now, Rask is banned. Rask, one of the favorite matches with him, so I don't know if we'll see that. So instead, they just pick up two firepowers. They seem to really like that Zuki play, and then Lockwood, just always a favorite. He's got so much utility, so much damage. He can continuously do damage, even if he doesn't have the best position, bouncing around the walls and do it from a safe area. Celeste on the other side, no surprise there. Some very popular firepowers going directly by the book. Finn's very popular. Celeste, I mean, all these names, all things you've seen before today.
Yeah, I'm kind of disappointed that we're not seeing more pocket picks, you know, specialty picks from these guys instead of, and there's Tidus once again for no value. Man, he is super popular now. Look out, solo queue. He is going to be showing up everywhere.
Tidus pick coming out from home. So back on to Cookie Cutters. Now, Cookie Cutters, what do you pick up here? You need a frontliner and a firepower. If you're going traditional, you could go triple firepower to try and burst down the enemy team, or you could take that rampart that is so strong against the Zuki ultimate if you have the shield available, which is what they are going to do.
Yeah, kind of surprised Asana didn't get picked up there by Cookie Cutters, but Rampart, always a good pickup against these front-loaded firepowers like Lockwood and Zuki, who have to have a clear line of sight to use most of their damage abilities on you. Now, Tidus, of course, as well, has nothing to go over that shield, so a good pickup there in my opinion.
We should mention that Zuki can take the Through Walls mod, which is probably why we saw it last round, and Zuki can go through the shields by Rampart if she does take those mods.
Look at that L pickup. I was just talking about wanting to see some pocket picks, and that's one we don't see very often. And of course, the Aurora, not a big surprise there. She's one of the most popular, but that L may be the story of the game.
L is able to do a lot of damage, but it's often spread out, and people generally like to focus, take down single members of the enemy team, and then get favorable matchups. So with L, you really have to do a tremendous amount of damage to impact the map. Now, she's definitely capable of it. It takes some good positioning, and we'll see if Cookie Cutters can show us a masterclass on L here. Because, man, if you get that overcharge run in, roll around, deal some damage, overcharge back out, and then just able to constantly buff yourself, avoid damage, you can do some very amazing things with L.
No doubt. I mean, she is, I think when she first came out,
whatever it takes.
I played a bunch of games with her. Of course, this was a while back before the ranked and everything, so it didn't really matter too much, but I think I won my first 10 games with her. She seemed really, really powerful, and the rolling mechanic for her basic attacks seems like it's really, really powerful to kind of dodge some damage coming in. But at this level of play, however, it's really difficult to juke your opponents because they've seen all this stuff before, guys. You know, they've been in all the games. They've played hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of matches, seen probably at least 100 L's on the enemy team by now.
Well, especially in this lineup. So L is very strong at dodging Nyx attacks, very strong at dodging Gray attacks. However, Zuki often aims so she can hit at least six of the, you know, nine squares you could be in. And same thing, Lockwood can bounce around the side, so it's going to be tough to really get her in a spot where this Zuki and this Lockwood, known for being able to hit a lot of squares at once, aren't going to be able to predict that, or just, even without predicting it, hit your basic square and happen to hit the rest too with explosion damage, with bounces, etc.
Yeah, just like you said, a lot of AoE coming in from their side, from no value side, and with the, you can have the Zuki throw down the big one, throw down the sticky bombs, and just kind of cover a whole giant area she could roll into. Lockwood, of course, spray and pray. Aurora with the ion cloud. Tidus doesn't really care if he ults, he hits half the map anyway. So it's going to be interesting, for sure. And it looks like Aw going to take on the L, and Remini going to be on the frontliner this time. Lava Cookie, of course, on the Celeste. Gobblenox on the Dr. Finn, so no change there. But looks like the firepower and the frontliner swapped roles for this match for Cookie Cutters.
All right, so once the teams do eliminate the extra slots, we are ready to roll here. Just a few seconds for them to select those mods. Again, they might say, you know, hey, maybe we want the through Walzuki to get through Remini, or maybe we just want to do the extra damage and I'll work around that wall. Hey, maybe we want to be able to avoid the pull. There's a lot of options to consider in these targeted mods and catalysts.
Yeah, on Cloudspire, I would probably personally go with Zuki with the full damage loadout and just avoid, just try to juke out the wall cooldown. Basically, make the rampart on Remini think that you're going to use your ultimate, get out in the middle, look like you're going to pull it off. You waste the wall, then you wait till the next turn. That could be a thing.
Of course, that does delay your turn. It's all about the mind games, what makes Atlas Reactor so much fun, so popular, and so easy to learn by heart the master. These mind games, will they jump, won't they jump, can I stay, can I shield, can I heal through it, all these different options, and you just have to read your opponents, predict them well enough. So we'll see who can make that happen as this map does start off.
All right, we're getting to the final match of the day. Cookie Cutters needs this win to take Whiteheart's spot at spot number 5. No Values fighting for honor and respect. Wants to pull a game off of them to show that, hey, we're going to be back next season even more powerful than before.
All right, looks like the first round of movement has begun. Gommel actually stayed in place. Not sure if they weren't able to lock in time or that was planned here.
Well, look at Lava Cookie's position on the Celeste. The traditional Celeste opening moves, you're going to be able to take up both of those buffs right away unless somebody decides to dash through them, which Tidus very well may do.
Dashes do happen to beat Celeste is the way to get around her here. But basically guaranteeing she'll get at least one of the two because the enemy team don't really have enough dashes unless J-Knight was to be bold enough to use theirs this early. Fruraz diving directly through, going to grab that might, definitely taking damage and actually blocking both shots, so no might for Lava Cookie, a slow and some damage, although Fruraz does take some themselves. Remini expecting the dash on them spins, but does not take any. Does walk over the trap.
It seemed like Lava Cookie predicted that entirely, just put both shots down onto Fruraz straight away, because I didn't see the other one trying to break off to the left at all, unless I missed it, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, of course. But all way off on his own over there on the L, trying to stay out of sight, out of mind, sneak up on somebody behind him.
But this is the power. They may still get two hits despite being completely out because of this roll before the shot. Remini's going to set up a wall to save Gommel from some damage, and with the heal and the shield down, their team's looking pretty good over there. However, Trasric is going to slow pretty much their entire team, set up a giant trap in case they stay in spot. Fruro's putting the dagger on Lava just in case they dash away as bombs blow up on J-Knight. He's going to bounce off the wall. Nothing big happening there. Lava Cookie's still just throwing hands down as a trap actually slows down Bright, and two traps not only slowed but rooted. Unfortunately, able to get over the wall, so doing significant damage with the might on Bright Shadow to the entire enemy team despite the healing.
That's the power of the Ion Cloud with mighted buff on there. 75 damage in one turn from a support character. And they're going to proc it one more time on Remini and Gommelnox unless they decide to dash out of there, which they would have to use their catalyst, so I doubt they're going to. That.
And with the shields and the high health, they may just tank this damage there. We will see exactly how it goes. Of course, they. But this is a lot of damage.
They're also standing in the middle of that big one as well.
Victory at any cost.
Turtle Pig coming out of Fruit Roz as he's in the middle of the enemy team. Bright Shadow going to weaken the entire... Well, most of the enemy team over there. Bombs going out from Lava Cookie just to reduce some vision and deal a little bit extra damage. Remini is going to spin, take some damage from the trap. Fruit Roz dealing 40 to each. They are going to regret standing here as Tasrik does 35 and 20 as well from the big one. In addition to a regular shot, 30 and 26. And then J-Knight just tremendous damage out of the blue team.
No value saying, we are here. We're not going anywhere. We're taking this game off you. Whether you like it or not, looks like they're winning in health bars, which health bars are a resource in this game by far right now. And it looks like Fruit Roz in kind of a bad way, but he is just kind of where he wants to be. He's in the thick of things, all right behind two squishy targets there over on the L. Probably going to try to play some damage now. Embrace the light.
And Bright Shadow heals go down on Fruit Roz. Fruit Roz dashes in to finish off Grommel Nox without any healing. He will go down here, and he did elect to do damage on Fruit Roz. Chazric able to throw some extra damage in on Remini, who did take so much damage a turn before. Blue team closing in on their targets. Finn going down. Lava Cookie being put in place by the heal. Just not able to move due to the knockback.
I got to point out some props for Bright Shadow Wolf on the Aurora. Excellent positioning so far in the match to be in the right place at the right time for his team. Just where your support has to be. Very aggressive movements from Bright Shadow Wolf, but only taking about a third of his health bar away so far to do it. And again, health bar is a resource, so it's okay to spend a little bit of it to get the job done.
Traps going directly down where Celeste is standing, spinning by Remini. Able to do some good damage to Fruit Roz as Maw tries to hit J-Knight, but with the cover, that won't do much. J-Knight bouncing shots into the back of Remini together with Fruit Roz will separate that robot into many different pieces and deal some damage to Lava Cookie. Lava able to walk away, Fruit Roz chasing. Surprised that they didn't put the trap wherever Lava Cookie was going to end up.
Complete flip from game number one, game two, going in favor of no value. That Titus is coming out strong this weekend for every team that picks him up. Seems like he is just putting on a show, and I'm super excited to see that.
Now it's just unfair.
Team's fully locked into this point. An overcharge coming in from Awe, able to run out to the second might buff. Looks like there might be conflict there though. Bright Shadow doing a little bit extra healing as Tasrik tries to predict maybe a roll or just some extra damage. Fruit Roz just little shots on Lava Cookie. Lava Cookie wisely runs away to the buff. Now, this is a smart move. However, Fruit Roz is able to follow, but you don't always have to deal damage. Sometimes it's better to just do a full run and get away from the enemy team, get some health on you.
Definitely, and you notice I keep harping on the Titus play, but Titus angled that attack, so just in case Lava Cookie decided to Catalyst Flash over the wall, he was still going to hit her there. So, excellent prediction play, along with doing the damage anyway.
And as everybody readies up for this round, looks like an unstoppable R ready to go despite whatever might happen. Grommel Nox able to get some nice healing down, some Lava Cookie not going to be out of it yet no matter what, but slows coming down from the big one. Lava Cookie able to do a double-handed hit on Fruit Roz, doing a lot of damage as Aw gets two members of the enemy team, but J-Knight returns the favor with his spread, and here comes the ultimate cataclysm from Fruit Roz, able to hit three members of the enemy team, significant damage. Bright Shadow finally getting caught in that trap, and that is a root trap, so this excellent positioning may not continue as they are stuck in place. Does use the ultimate to do significant damage. Here comes Rampart pulling his frontliner away from his teammate, saving her. He's gonna maybe dash right back in though.
Thank you for flying, Air Remini. I hope you enjoy your flight. Have a nice trip. Basically, but Fruit Roz doing over 110 damage in that one turn with his ultimate. Excellent off from the Titus. Again, I keep harping on the Titus play this weekend, but it has been excellent off the charts, man. I would not be surprised to see him show up a lot in the games in Atlas coming up.
Remini gonna throw that shield out. Fruit Roz's might shout, not able to hit much besides Awe there. The dash from Fruit Roz will go ahead and hit Remini, not dashing all the way to Lava Cookie like they wanted to. Looks like the trap does hit J-Knight, Nice setup by Awe, able to just slow down that Lockwood. Tazrak just sitting in the corner, pounding out damage, and because he was not able to dash away the way, Remney's shield doing so much work, able to take down that Titus.
Yeah, today the day goes to Remney's frontliner Rampart pick with that big-time shield doing damage, finishing the job. All in a little bit of trouble, but has the ultimate, has the might buff, but only has maybe two shots or two individuals that he can get. Bright Shadow Wolf and Jay Knight both. I mean, Bright Shadow Wolf can't get away. Sarik also is in that, but Suzuki ult is scary. You don't want to take that.
Remney knows the basic shield is down, so is going to dash out of this one, as I do believe the ultimate is going down. Bright Shadow going to give a nice heal to Jay Knight so they won't go down pretty much no matter what here.
Ultimate ability activated.
There goes the taunt from the red, white, and blue. As Remney dashes over to the other side, there was no ultimate coming out from Tazrak there. So Tazrak still stuck in place, doesn't have a lot of the enemy team to focus on, could probably hit Gommel as well.
Celeste going down there, 3-1 now in favor of no value. Jay Knight taking him out with the Lockwood ultimate. Did not expect him to go that way. I'm sure Lavacookie didn't as well, just stood there and took it. That's one ultimate off the field for two more turns.
It'll be powerful when they come back, but if it was used now, it might have a chance to return, so now it is going to be stuck in limbo and probably only one per game.
This will make an impact.
Awe is going to overcharge, run to the health, and hopefully return with an ultimate of their own pretty soon, but blue team is going to inch up the map here, trying, looks like, chase down where this Gommel's going to go, as Jay Knight gets a little bit extra damage on him. Tazrak focusing them as well, despite Remney being directly next to him and poking him with that giant sword. And blue team advancing towards Gommel. Gommel's in a tough spot despite Remney being in the middle of the opposing team.
Yeah, that's another example. L proved you right once again. This is sometimes the best part of Valor is to just run around the horn, pick up that health globe, and get in a better position to assist your team, especially when you're low health there. Was behind the wall, was safe, but just decided to run around, try not to get into danger just yet.
Here come the lock-ins. Here comes that early shield from Remney. Furuz is going to go ahead and put a dagger on Rommel since they could not hit him from that far away. J-Knight hits from the rear. Double damage going down on Tazrak and Furuz. Bright Shadow going to throw down the trap, which does hit from above, so it hits everybody. So it does hit through the shield. Gommelnox throwing down the ultimate here. Locking down multiple members of the enemy team inside of that Ion Cloud. And Awe's now in an excellent position.
Oh man, this is an excellent L ult, but they've got to expect it. They've got to see that it's going to come. Does he hang on to it or does he let it fly right now? At the same time, Remney, I want to point out a Rampart having some really good shields, not blocking a whole lot of damage coming in, but doing the damage back and slowing people down. So excellent work there with the shield in a kind of an unorthodox manner.
Here comes the ultimate from Tazrak, able to tag multiple members of the other team, three of them. However, Oz going to use one themselves, and Remney fetters the enemy team in the Ion Cloud, well avoiding the damage. Gommelnox will do a little bit extra. Bright Shadow trying to get the heals out to survive. Oh, that is their own Ion Cloud, actually. Jay Knight able to shoot Gommelnox, but despite being in cover, will trigger that knife, doing the extra damage that allows this ultimate ability from Tazrak to take them down. Too many missiles as Awe blasts three members of the enemy team for a lot of damage, so traded a fish for just so much damage.
Now here's the cool thing about Atlas Reactor. Cookie Cutters are down 1-4 in the scoreboard, but you notice on the blue side, on no value side, two members are super low. One is at half health, one is at 2/3 almost, so they're super low. They could easily swing this in just one turn.
Bright Shadow going to go ahead and heal themselves to see if they can survive. I don't think it'll be enough here. Surprises. Trap going down on really the easiest spot for blue team to put any defense up from. Lavacookie going to be able to put a nice 34 down. 32 from Remney means any damage from R would finish us off. Tazrak jumping to the heal. the knockback from Bright Shadow Wolf going directly over the trap from J-Knight. So Bright Shadow does manage to live. They thought they had it. They did not expect that heal to do as much damage as it is. You can always hit alt to see exactly what everybody has available to them. But able to live with 4 health.
The positioning for Bright Shadow Wolf right behind that wall. Remedy can't attack him. Lava Cookie's alt can't reach. Maybe a smoke bomb. But that's about it. And all backed off on the L, so in no range to do any damage this turn.
Well, on those, if they go down, it is death, so had to stay away for at least one more turn. Coming back into the action now. Firuz dashing to Remedy. They're trying to pick up a kill as best they can, wherever they can. Does get rooted by this trap. Lava Cookie able to put some damage down on Tazrek. As J-Knight and Bright Shadow will both focus down Remedy, able to do some significant damage, even Trazric. So Bright Shadow, Trazric, J-Knight, all focusing through Ruz as well. There was just no hope for Remedy as they take entirely too much damage and go down.
Victory.
Very well played by No Value, pulling the game off of Cookie Cutters in a dominant fashion that turnaround. So excellent job there for them. Unfortunately for Cookie Cutters, they do not make the sweep, so they're going to sit down in sixth position going into the tournament. In that sixth seed, Whiteheart retains their position in fifth position. Even though they did forfeit their matches today, they don't move any. And, well, that's going to do it, guys.